Horton is an open source Nicom server, which is easy to install and provides a simple web-based user interface for browsing the data it contains. Once installed, Horton runs as a service, meaning that it can run continuously in the background and will respond to requests on certain ports. It will typically listen on two ports, one for the incoming DICOM connections and one for incoming HTTP connections for the web interface. Let's start Horton from the Services panel in Windows. As a service, it doesn't start a graphical user interface or even a terminal. It runs in the background. We can check that it works by connecting to it with our browser, the port specified for HTTP connections, here 8042. We get to the lookup part of the interface where we can search for patients or studies. Before going further, let's take a quick look at the Horton configuration. Configuration is stored as a JSON file. First, it defines a name for the server, which will be displayed in the web interface. Next, we can use the Storage Directory option to configure where Horton will store incoming DICOM files. You can also find in this file the configuration of the HTTP server, with the port on which it will listen. We always have to make sure not to use a port that is used by another program. In the same way, we define the parameters of the DICOM server with the application entity title of the service provider, as well as the port it will listen on. We also define which transfer syntax we want the service provider to accept. Finally, we can define known DICOM entities with which the system will be able to communicate. Here, for instance, we added a store SCP DICOM entity for each of the computers in the lab's local network. As we will see later on, this is necessary to be able to execute CMove operations. Let's now quickly look at what we can do in the web interface. We have one patient in the database at the moment. We can see a patient page with a list of all the studies for this patient. In the study page, we have the list of series. We also have a link to a web viewer called Ozymis, which provides an interface for viewing the image. In this viewer, we have some very basic operations, such as changing the contrast or the luminosity. We can zoom into the image or pan. We also have some measuring tools, which can use the metadata from the DICOM file to compute real distances in millimeters from the distance in pixels. We can also check the raw value of any pixel in the image, or add annotations. At the series level, we also have access to the more basic Horton viewer, which has less functionalities. At the instance level, we can see all the DICOM tags for the file, as we would by executing the DICOM dump command. Also preview the image, and we can see a summary of the main information contained in the tags organized in the usual DICOM hierarchy of patient, study, series, and instance. In the next video, we'll see how we can store images in the server with CStore requests.